Okay, let's check a moment how the deformers work. They are meant to be used with the guide hair, and actually we have six different ones. Let's start with the sphere eyes. You see that when I apply it, it's draping the hair almost like if it was doing on a sphere. And you can of course reverse the action. So as you notice, this could be a very helpful process to create a simple style just in a few clicks. And also you can apply also the effects, sorry, the deformers also on different axes. So for example, instead of working on the y-axis, I can use it on the z. And so in this case, you see I'm really can create very odd shapes. And of course, I can combine these two styling so that in a few clicks I already have a decent style that I can enhance even further. You can of course also enable the preview to see how your hair will actually look. And at any time you can of course also reset. Alright, so we have also the curl effect. You can obviously mix all the effects, so just add the curl effect. I can couple it with the sphere eyes. Alright, so. This is the preview on. And I can use the length deformer to increase the size or decrease it. And another nice deformer is the tilt roots, which will, well, this was too much. Let me go back and try it again. Alright, so it will create a nice variety by bending the hair in random directions. And we have the swirl effect, which can also be applied on different axes. And the taper effect, which is very useful because it will allow to decrease the hair length on one side, sorry, on one direction or the other. This is very helpful, especially when designing animal figures. I'll show you why. Let me go back to Studio and load, sorry, and select the pup. I'm going to load it in. Look at my hair. Choose the coat surface. Grow the guide hair. And as we are done, I'm going to show you how the taper can be very helpful. So you see, here we have a very mess situation with by our guides, but that's no problem. I'm going to taper, so you see that the length will be smoothly decreased toward the pads, and I of course also decrease the length a little bit. I'm using the taper even more. I might use also the sphere eyes so that the fur will be smoothly bent towards the bottom. And if you remember previous tutorial, at this point, this could be a very nice moment to use our scale in smooth mode so that I can quickly shape my dog fur. Alright, so you see, in few clicks I've done it. Could also use it a little bit also on the tail. So you see, with the brush in smooth mode, the action in this, also in this case, especially here on the tail, is very strong toward the end, because that's where I pointed the brush center to, and will gently decrease as it moves toward the rest of the body. So at this point, well, might use also a little bit more of taper if I like. Remember that each of these deformers can be applied on the three axes, so you might want to experiment a little bit how that affects hair styling. And well, if I now decide to spherize the guides, which might take some seconds because we have many guiders here. Alright, you see, in a little bit I've very quickly, in 3-4 minutes, I've created a nice full preset with for my dog. And of course, remember that you can save it through the save icon here at the top.